Hi everybody, it is Tuesday morning. It is the day your module opens and I'm just posting your video. What does that say about me as a character? Does that say something about, well, let's see, did I fall asleep before I should have posted? Did I forget? Am I that lazy and disorganized? Well, maybe those things are all true. I can't really say. But here I am talking to you from my cluttered car. It's still drenched. It's early morning. My hair's still damp. I'm wearing a dress that features cats, but I think maybe you should know something about me. I do have a cat, but the dress doesn't really say as much as the cat fur that clings to it. That indicates I have a cat. There's so many ways I can characterize myself right now. Maybe you could do the same. We can characterize ourselves and the other people in our stories by describing their physical features. We can describe their actions, their behaviors, and the way they speak. Their dialogue, their voices on the page tell us an awful lot about who our characters are. So this week you have a blog in which you get to characterize yourself or others in conversation. So you are going to use dialogue, setting, and scene to describe, to characterize. So to be clear, setting is where things take place. This is my cluttered car. I am talking to you. Well, it doesn't look all that cluttered when I show it that way. That's probably for the best. I don't want to show you the floor of my car. I can characterize the setting. I'm in front of a park. You can't really see it, but I'm in front of a park. And it's a beautiful morning, even after it's been raining. You can characterize through physical description, mannerisms, behaviors, and as I say, dialogue. So have fun with this, play with this, practice using voice, not only your own voice, but the voices of your characters, and see if you can make them show up as distinctive. If you have questions this week, send me a message or an email, and I look forward to hearing you speak on the page. Have fun. Bye.